Hello student, myself Nimesh Prabhakar. Welcome to Automotive Electronics lecture series. In my previous lecture, we discussed about the modern automotive system. Now, in this lecture, we discuss about the evolution of automotive electronics. Then we discuss about the need for electronics in the automobile. And last we discussed about the electronic system used in automobile at different place. So in this lecture, we will discuss about these three topics. So we start with the first one, evolution of automotive electronics. The era of electronics start with the invention of semiconductor device, MOSFET, and evolve into the more complex system such as electronics control unit. So in the short form, we can say as a ECU, electronics control unit. It is a really very important device that control all the electronic system in the car. So first one, the era of this electronic system that used in the car is start the basic from the evolution of the semiconductor device. Now, it was around the year of the 1978 when the General Motors introduced the first ever electronic system in an automobile. So General Motors is the one company that introduced the electronic system in the car. Before that, just mechanical system is used inside the car. But in the 1978, this company like the General Motors that introduced the electronic system first time in the car. An ECU is essentially an embedded system that is built on the automotive grade microcontroller. An electronics control unit, that in the short form we can say as an ECU, is a small device in a vehicle body that is responsible for controlling a specific function. So here in this figure we can see the ECU, and ECU is located inside the car. So this is the one type of microcontroller we can say that control all the electronic system inside the car. An ECU is able to control the electronic system and the subsystem in the vehicle. Now, we discussed about the move from mechanical to electronics. The last 30 years have seen rapid technological invention in the automotive electronics, driven primarily by the advancement in the semiconductors and the related software that control the system. Now, we discuss about the short history, how the evolution of the automotive electronics come. So in the 1970, introduction of the electronics for the engine control. We discussed in the 1978, the General Motors that used first time the electronic system in the car. Then in the 1980, the anti-lock braking system is introduced. So here, we know that ABS, anti-lock braking system, that system is introduced in the 1980. Now next one is the early 90s, the airbag become standard. So in the 1990s, the airbag system for the safety purpose is introduced inside. Now in the late 90s, rapid extension of the body electronics, seat monitors, then instrument panel, lighting, auto locking system, and the keyless entry system is in the early 2000s. The system that introduced like the endpoint management, including sophisticated audio and video system, signal seek via the satellite, like we can see the for the navigation purpose, the GPS and other navigation system is introduced inside the car. And making capability and satellite radio system is used inside the car. So this is the, we can see the how decade wise, or we can say and the year wise, the technology is introduced inside the car. Now why we need from move from electronics in the car? That means why we need to introduce electronic system in the car? So mainly basic three reasons behind this. First one reason is to reduce the emission, that means carbon dioxide emission, or we can say NOx emission, to reduce the emission in the car. Now second one reason is to improve the safety, and last one reason is the consumer demand. So because of these three reasons, we need for the electronics in the automobile. So we discussed the first one, need is to reduce the emission. So we know that the automobile, that means the car that produce the gases, harmful gases like the carbon dioxide, carbon monoxide in the exhaust. So to reduce or to protect the environment from these gases, we have to introduce the electronic system in the car. And this system is really helpful to reduce the emission in the car. So without the electronics control of the vehicle system, emission from engine could not have been reduced by so much. The legislator seek continue reduction in the emission, and the vehicle manufacturer have been able to achieve a tremendous result. But without electronics, it would not have been possible to reduce emission to anywhere close to the current low level. So without this electronic system, it is not possible to reduce the emission level at this low level. Now second one need, or we can say, to improve the safety. So by introducing the safety gadget or the electronic system inside the car, we can improve the safety of the driver and the passenger. Safety systems such as the anti-lock braking system and airbags, seatbelt pre-tensioner system could not function anywhere like as efficiently or rapidly without the use of the electronics. So this system is really helpful to reduce the rate of the accident, and also it provides the comfort inside the car. And third one reason for the need for the electronics in the automobile is the consumer demand. Not very long ago, only the most expensive vehicle had electronics or computer control luxuries. We all know that. However, it is now expected that cheaper high volume vehicle will also have electronically controlled system, including the ABS and airbag system. So we know that right now in the cheaper car like the Alto car or in the Hyundai model car, we can see the 5 lakh price car or the 8 lakh price car, this airbag system and ABS system is available. So it is the consumer demand. So that's why we need to introduce the electronics in the automobile. So these are the reason why we need to introduce the electronics in the automobile. Now we discuss second one point, the electronic system used in the automobile at different place. There are different electronic system are used in an automobile for automobile operation, like to enhance the driving act, fuel efficiency, comfort of the driver as well as rider. And embedded system playing an essential role in automobile architecture because they use in the anti-lock braking system, telematic music system, safety airbag system and radio, then tracking auxiliary system. So here in the different place we can see the use of the electronic system. So first one we start with the different place like the engine electronics, then transmission electronics, then chassis electronic system, then passive safety, then driver assistance, then passenger comfort, then entertainment system. So these are the system, the electronic system used in the car. So now first one we start with the engine electronics. So this day ECU is used to control the engine. The ECU, that means engine control unit, is essential electronic part in the automobile. An engine control unit in an automobile can be used to control the function like rate of the fuel injection, NOx emission, controlling of the emission, then the throttle position control, then turbocharger, cooling system control, and the oxidation catalytic converter. So here the engine is also used the electronic system to control this system. Now next one is the transmission electronics. So it is used for controlling the transmission system, mostly while shifting the gear from enhanced shift comfort and to lesser torque interrupt. The communication between ECU and the transmission control can be done by exchanging information and control and the sensor signal for that process. Now next one is the passive safety system. The passive safety system is all about learning and practicing of plant, building, apparatus and instruction to the reduce the incident and result of the traffic accident of the motor vehicle. Now next one is the chassis electronics. The chassis system include electronic subsystem in a car which monitor different parameter and control activities like ABS, that means anti-lock braking system, then EBD, that means electronic brake distribution, then next one is TCS, that means traction control system, next one is the PA, that means parking assistance, and last one is the ESP, that means electronic stability program. Now next one is the driver assistance. This system are used for increasing automobile safety, road safety. This system include different assist system like lane assistant, speed, path, blind spot detection and control system like the adaptive cruise control. Now the passenger comfort. The automotive electronic used in an automobile for passenger comfort mainly include automatic climate control, automatic wiper, adjustment of the electronic stick with the memory, then automatic headlamp for the automatic beam adjustment, then automatic cooling for the adjusting the temperature. So this is the passenger comfort system. Next one is the entertainment system. So the entertainment system used in automobile mainly include the vehicle audio and navigation system and the data access. So these are the electronic system used in the automobile at different places. So here in this lecture, first we discuss about the evolution of the automotive electronics. Then next we discuss about the need for the electronics in the automobile. And last we discuss about the electronic system used in the automobile at different places. Thank you.